Well, the avalanche of unprecedented happenings from this president, his White House at times calls for perspective. This is certainly one of those times, like when the president uses language like this about the growing scandal around him.
Joe Biden and his son are corrupt. All right. But the fake news doesn't want to report it because they're Democrats. If that ever happened, if a Republican ever did what Joe Biden did, if a Republican ever said what Joe Biden said, they'd be getting the electric chair by right now. Look at the double standards. You people ought to be ashamed of yourself. And not all. We have some great journalists around, but you got a lot of crooked journalists. You're crooked as hell.
Lieutenant Colonel Ralph Peters joins me now. Colonel Peters, when you hear language like that from the President of the United States, he's talking in front, by the way, of the President of Poland. I'm wondering what you make of it. What does it say to you that the U.S. is even in a position where its citizens have to wonder if their president may have asked a foreign leader to investigate a political rival?
Well, it truly is an utterly, utterly unprecedented situation. And shames us. It shames us all. It doesn't just shame Democrats. It shames all Americans. And the founding fathers, of course, never foresaw anyone like Trump. How could they? And when he talks, you know, there are many sides to government corruption. I personally know of nothing for which Joe Biden can be accused of being corrupt. Trump, on the other hand, is a paragon of corruption in every possible respect in his presidency and his life before the presidency. That said, you know, I'm not a fan of Elizabeth Warren. She can't do basic math. But she is absolutely right about the pervasiveness of corruption, including what I would call legal corruption in our government. And so while Joe Biden appears to be above reproach, it is a legitimate question for we the people to ask, you know, what qualifications did his son have to sit on a Ukrainian gas corporation's board? Trump is something new. He's a low point in our history. He does such damage on a daily basis to our image. The only saving grace is our allies have already written him off and are just hoping for change.
And yet, there's something about saying that kind of thing in front of the president of Poland that is interesting to me, because it does give license to a president of Poland or any regime that wants to crack down on reporters or just label any kind of information that they don't like, you know, fake. When the president of the United States is doing that, I feel like it gives license to thugs around the world.
Well, of course it does. And there is plenty of fake news. And it's primarily on the internet and sponsored by extreme right-wing sites, although extreme left-wing sites get their share too. But Trump, the biggest mistake people make about Trump is using the word leader or leadership. Trump is not a leader of any sort. Trump is an entertainer, and he is a brilliant entertainer, one of the most successful entertainers in history. But leadership, you know, I think about this a lot in relation to Trump. And, you know, the military rules apply. A leader should put his mission first, then his men before himself. And Trump is just the opposite. You know, in the military, there's a rule that officers eat last. When you're out on maneuvers, you make sure every single soldier is fed. And then if there's anything left, you get the cold powdered eggs in the winter. And Trump is just the opposite of that. Trump eats first and eats as much as he can. He doesn't care if there's any leftovers for anybody else. So from my experience of leadership, and I have been privileged to work for and with some magnificent leaders, and Trump doesn't qualify as a leader on any single count.
The president said he's the most transparent president in U.S. history. Clearly his White House is not. He is transparent, probably not how he means, in that he is the most, it is so clear what he is thinking, and he says all the things he is thinking, whether it's on Twitter. He told George Stephanopoulos he would have no problem taking information from a foreign government to use against an opponent or if it would help him in an election. This is just one step beyond that, and it doesn't seem like he has a problem with it. The idea of, you know, asking a foreign government to do something that's going to attack his own political opponent and help an election, and why not use, you know, the weight of not giving military aid. I mean, if you believe in the first one of accepting information from a foreign government, morally, why not just then request it?
No, Trump cares about Trump, cares about Trump, cares about Trump. And that's where it ends. He doesn't care about others, maybe a little bit about his family. But, you know, it's telling that, Donald Trump doesn't seem to have a single intimate, lifelong friend. He must be, in his own peculiar way, a terribly lonely man. Nothing really makes him happy. When do you see Trump looking genuinely happy or delighted with life? You know, he may be president of the United States, but by God, every morning he has to get up and be Donald Trump. And that's a curse upon anybody.
Lieutenant Colonel Ralph Peters, appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.